Ken and I are in talks to be a new business owner at the 310 North Main Street Suite with a fabulous specialty cheese shop. And there is no cheese shop or any specialty bake like that between San Francisco and Portland. So I'm trying to create a community of people to come and have specialty cheese and cheese events and be a hub for that. And Andrea gave me the opportunity to do that in Phoenix. And my kids go to Discovery Corner for 5 years now in Phoenix, and my son will be going to the elementary school. But as far as the ordinance go, I'm looking at all the things, and the code for the city center plan provides for a nice downtown environment for my business, and VAR 1802 conflicts with that plan. It seems that as far as criteria, E goes, the hardship was self-imposed. Well, I don't, the hardship as far as the two-lane, the one-lane to two-lane issue has some arguments to it, but the hardship as far as filling in the parking spaces on the streets, I don't see that hardship. I don't, why does it need to be filled in? Seems to be creating a hardship instead of removing ones. So that's this part of the variance that I think the criteria is not answering or going against. Like, as far as criteria A, the proposed variance will not be materially detrimental to the purpose of this code, which is the beautiful business environment, to any other applicable policy standards and to other properties in the same land use districts in Minnesota City. Well, this code is what protects Phoenix business owners, like my future self, from hardship, such as taking away parking or direct street access onto the street, that the variance kind of clearly goes against that, against the whole, it does create a material detrimental. That's criteria A.
30 seconds.
No, yes, thank you. And then criteria F, the variance requested is the minimal variance that would eliminate the hardship. It would not eliminate any hardship, it will create some. The part of the variance about parking removal and not so much about the two lane. So if you could consider to accept this appeal and reject the VAR 1802 to accommodate the different variance, that would be very helpful to us as well. Thank you.
Christine Todd. Thank you. not asking or inviting or soliciting some type of comment and like participation from the people who would be the most directly affected by it.
3 seconds.
And so the fact that nobody like wanted any input from the people who would be the most affected basically is another factor which makes me think that the council should approve this appeal because the planning commission did not have all of the information, it wasn't all accurate, and some of the required criteria were not being met. So, I urge you guys to approve the appeal.
Your shot.
Good.
Stops.